Hey guys, so before diving into today's video, let me drop some info about why infographics are just so damn effective. Our brain processes visual information 60 times faster than it does text. People also remember 80% of what they see and do, only 20% of what they read, and then 10% of what they hear. And infographics are 30 times more likely to be read by people than a simple text article. The most effective infographics have great visuals, awesome structure, and will take their readers through a bit of a story or maybe an informational journey. So in today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to use a free online tool to make this awesome infographic in less than 10 minutes. Let's do it. So for this tutorial, we're going to be using a tool that's found at piktochart.com. It's free for you to sign up and it's super easy to use. So once you log in, under the infographic tab over here, you're going to find some free templates for you to use for your designs. You can also find some pro templates, so you would have to upgrade to their paid account to be able to use these. But you can also click down here in the bottom left-hand corner on the Inspire Me section, and it's going to show you lots of different designs that other people have created using Piktochart if you're just looking for inspiration. And then you can always start from scratch and try and replicate these awesome designs. So we're just going to jump back, and what I'm going to do is just click on Create a New Infographic so I can show you what it looks like when you start from scratch. So when you first begin, you're just going to have this blank template over here. So we want to go ahead and select that and just click delete. It's also this long, big canvas. So we want to actually go ahead and drag that up and we're going to shrink it. So we're going to be working with something called blocks. So you can see over here, you can clone a block or you can just add a new one. Cloning a block means that it's going to replicate everything you do here with text and images, whereas just adding a new one is going to bring over nothing except for the background color, which is white at the moment. But what I want to do is I want to start off by just putting in a new background color. So I'm just going to go ahead and select my background color here. And I want to add some text. I could just use these categories up here, but I'm going to go ahead and use a pre-made one over here. Now just double clicking into it, and I'm going to go ahead and write our business name, and this is going to be the Living to Rome story. So we're going to be creating an infographic which is going to be about our five top destinations for 2017. So making that larger, and I'm going to snap that into place. You want to make sure that this is switched on, as that's what's going to allow you to align elements on your page with other elements on the page. If it's not selected, then you're moving around freely, but you actually want to be snapping into place so you know when you're centered. And now I'm going to just go ahead and add a little bit more text over here. So I want to just double click into this. Make that 2017 and change the font so it matches. And I'm going to increase my font size over here as well. Now what I want to do is I want to rotate this, as it's going to be just directly in the corner. And as you hover over the rotate, you can see it's telling you that if you hold down shift as you're rotating, it's going to allow you to move in increments of 15 degrees. The reason that's important is because it's going to allow you to have different elements overlapping on top of each other but being rotated in the exact same way. So I'll show you what I mean by going over to graphics. I'm going to select a shape here. I am going to go ahead and make that white. And I'm just going to drag that into more of a rectangle. And now if I twist it by holding down my shift key, now it's just rotated it perfectly to the same degrees as my 2017. Which is great. Now I want to select the arrange icon over here and click send backwards so it's behind my numbers, and I'm just going to use the arrows on my keyboard to shift it up, and that looks good. Now I could click into my text and maybe arrange the letters to be spread a little bit wider and center that a little bit better. Yeah, that looks good. So now I want to go ahead and add a new block. This one's going to have a bit of a different background here. So I'm going to select our blue. I'm going to go back to text and I'm going to select this frame over here and snap that into the middle. So I'm going to go and just widen that a little bit. So now we want this to say our favorite destinations for the year. And I'm just going to double click down here. And I'm going to write so many adventures. Now in the middle here is where our interactive map is going to go. So I'm going to head over to Tools and click on Maps. Now you could just select the countries over here or go by regions, but I actually want to go ahead and select the whole world. And I'm going to change the color. Now you could keep the border, but I'm actually going to choose not to in this case. And you could use this column or additional columns to add different values to each country. So when somebody hovers over it, it's going to display those different properties. But actually, I want to go ahead and right click and remove this column. And I'm just going to search by the top five countries that I want to display. So I'm going to go with Canada. And I'm going to change the color for it so we can see it better. And Australia, Greece, Hungary, and Vietnam. Perfect. So you can definitely see them there, and I'm going to go ahead and insert the map there. Now I'm just going to move that over in the middle, and I'm going to go ahead and add a new block. Now these are going to be slightly smaller. I'm going to go ahead and drag that up, and this one's going to have a different background. We're going to go back to our orange. Right, so now we're going to get a little bit funky with this, and we're going to go over to graphics and photo frame. And I'm actually going to use the letters of the countries overlaid with the photos that we took in that country to make this graphic really stand out. So we're going to start over with Canada, so we need a C. I'm going to go ahead and select my text to complete this graphic. And I'm going to select the correct font that we've been using throughout this infographic. And where you actually place it is up to you, but I'm going to go with the center. And now we want to head over to uploads. I'm going to select the photo that we took in Canada. I want to make sure my element is selected and just drag and drop. Now, if you double click on it, it's going to allow you to edit the photo so that it makes more sense, so you can actually see it in the sea. You could actually stretch that out a little bit more so you can see us both. That looks good. And now I'm just going to go into some light speed here, so you don't have to see me do this four more times, but I'm going to be using the exact same strategies, so let's do that. And you could then also spruce it up with some icons. So if you head on over to graphics and you go to shapes and icons, you can actually search for icons, or you can just scroll through them as well. But I already know the ones that I'm going to use, so I'm just going to go ahead and add those in. So then all that's left to do is click on download. And on the free version, you can download PNG, and you can download medium or normal quality. And you can also download it as individual blocks, but I'm happy with downloading it as one long infographic. And then when you open it up on your computer, it'll look just like this. And the only difference between the free and paid version is the fact that you'll have this white bar at the very bottom telling you that it's been made with Piktochart. Easiest way to do it is just to crop it right out, and you can do this really, really easily, just like that. And there's our beautiful new infographic. So I hope you guys really enjoyed that mini tutorial, and if you'd like to learn more about how you can improve your visual marketing or just your online presence overall, then make sure to check out the link in the description of the video for your access to our design school. And if you like this video, remember to like it, subscribe to our channel, and let me know what you thought in the comments. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, keep creating the life you love.